You know, you don't need to be super hyper indigenous. You don't need to be this person who's, you know, smudging and praying. It's not about that. It's about just being truth to yourself.
Yeah.
And then obviously using ingredients that are, that you got to be loyal to. I mean, we got to respect ourselves. We have to be very respectful to the ingredients we've been given. Think about, you know, Italian food, Mediterranean food, French food. All this stuff is all a big part of who we are. But I just think that when it comes to indigenous food, indigenous people don't even understand indigenous food.
In the Junos, they have an indigenous category, but indigenous is not a genre. Like, what's indigenous music? It's not a genre. It's not rock and roll.
It's not jazz.
By giving them an indigenous label is a challenging place to put people. So when it comes to culinary work, I hear what you're saying. The fact that our land, where we're from, absolutely influences and impacts what we put out.
Well, and that's the whole terroir thing too. I mean, like, so moose, elk, does it got to be wild game to be indigenous? No, it can be anything. As long as it's from this terroir. This is bison territory.
Yeah.
Right? That was our diet. That was our staple diet. But then if you go all the way to the West Coast, which would be Prince Rupert and King Cole, that's going to be seafood. Indigenous food is not being celebrated. Indian tacos, bannock. It's not us. Bannock isn't even, it's from the Scots.
Scottish, yeah.
So then you got Indian tacos. That's from the southern of the U.S. So, I mean, here we are celebrating stuff that's not really who we are. Am I more indigenous because I hunt and I fish? Am I more indigenous than you?
Right.
No. You know, I think that we need to understand what that means out there. And, you know, trees, willows, snow, spring, all this stuff evokes, it just completely evokes emotion.